Let us discuss the significance of RMS current which we have calculated. We know that for a time varying current I, say we talk about the AC current which is given as a function of time, the total heat produced when it is passed through a resistance R in time T1 to T2 is, this heat we can directly write integration of I square R dt, which is integrated from T1 to T2. Here this is the time varying AC current. And similarly we can say if a current IDC, which is a direct current, pass through a resistance R, then heat produced in same time is this heat, we can write say this H1, this H2, this can be written as IDC square R multiplied by T2 minus T1. As current does not change with time, we can directly use I square R delta T. Now say if this heat and this heat are same, if H1 is equals to H2, this implies, see what we are getting here, this IDC square R T2 minus T1 is equals to integration from T1 to T2 IAC square R dt. Here R gets cancelled out and see what we are getting for the value of IDC. It is under the root 1 by T2 minus T1 integration from T1 to T2 IAC square dt. You can see this is the same RMS value, IRMS, which we obtained by using the square root of the average of square of the AC current. That means this RMS value of current is directly giving us an effective DC current with which the same amount of thermal energy can be produced in a resistance which AC produces in the given time in the same resistance. So here we have got another definition for the root mean square current as well as its significance in different kind of mathematical calculations. Let's carry on with the next sheet. Now as we have just calculated that RMS current is defined as the DC value which produces the same amount of heat and a resistance R. So here we can also write down that RMS value of a given alternating current can be defined as that DC value which produces same heat in a resistance which the AC of which we are calculating RMS value produces in that resistance in same duration. That means if we are given with a resistance R and a time varying alternating current f of t is flowing, then for a given duration delta t we can directly write the heat produced will be equals to IRMS, which is the RMS value of this AC current square R delta t. Directly we can use RMS value of AC as the effective DC value. For any AC current, RMS current is also called effective DC value of a given AC. Whenever we require to calculate the amount of heat produced or power relations are concerned.